All right, 6:16 now on this Wednesday morning. We're starting the day dry and mild. We'll time out some rain for you in just a moment. Want to quickly show you our hometown scramble winner for today, Linda. Linda P. So congratulations to you for winning today. Just remember to email us weather3@wfsb.com the size of shirt you want, a large or extra large. All right, so early warning pinpoint Doppler here within the borders of Connecticut. We're dry for now, but that will change as we head towards, say, the later morning and then certainly through the afternoon hours as rain becomes likely. So we've got some limited sunshine, clouds out there. We'll continue to increase, looking live from New Haven toward 360 State Street. A nice view coming in from the Northwest Hills with our iCam view in Torrington. Sun up today was about 5 minutes ago at 6:12. Our view from New London as well, showing the mostly cloudy sky there. A nice scene from Storrs. More a clear sky here than cloud cover as the sun is rising. And you can see the sun there as well, just cresting the horizon, looking live from Hartford. And it's more the same from Middletown. A very calm, tranquil scene there, looking downstream of the Connecticut River. So temperatures, south winds are, Bob reports 58 degrees. Patrick in Simsbury is at 63, and Ed in Killingworth checks in at 62. These temperatures across the state considerably milder and more in line with where they should be for this time of day, this time of year, compared to the last several days when we've had, Monday morning, Tuesday morning lows in the 40s in some of the usual colder spots. So 62 right now in Hartford, 64 for New Haven. And throughout the region, while again we're dry here in Connecticut for now, clearly there's moisture streaming northward from off the Atlantic. We've got a cold front off to the west that's heading eastward. So all these ingredients are going to come together to produce rain that could be heavy at times later this afternoon and this evening. So on the big picture, high pressure is moving offshore. That's allowing the slow moving cold front. We've been talking about it now for the past several days. It's finally working into the region. At the same time, we've got Tropical Storm Aaron off the southeastern coast of the U.S. Moisture from this storm is going to be drawn overhead and enhance the threat for some heavier rain later today as the center of the storm passes well offshore. So here's the situation with the National Hurricane Center, the official forecast track taking up toward the Canadian Maritimes tomorrow night into early Friday morning. So for Atlantic facing coastline, larger swells, rough surf, rip current concerns for sure. But it's later today that some of that tropical moisture again gets drawn northward here into southern New England. That's what we'll show you on Futurecast. Tomorrow's weather today, 7 o'clock this morning. As the clock moves forward in time, rain becomes likely at least scattered showers, I'd say late morning, early afternoon, picking up an intensity a bit as we head through the evening commute time. And the front off to the west at 6 o'clock heads in our direction, furthering the threat for rain, possibly even some thunderstorms, 10, 11 o'clock tonight. Then it's in the early overnight hours that the rain winds down from west to east. And by this time tomorrow, looking for clearing to take place. And for our Thursday, a lot of sunshine. And temperatures tomorrow will be, say, between 80 and 85. So a nice day on tap for tomorrow. Now, the concern, of course, with the rain being too heavy in a brief window of time is for poor drainage nuisance type flooding. So we could see an inch or two of rain here within the borders of Connecticut, perhaps some heavier amounts along the 395 corridor, especially southeastern Connecticut. The heaviest of the rain from the storm system altogether likely cross eastern Massachusetts and as well into parts of Rhode Island. That's where we could see 4 to 5 inches of rain, and that's where a flash flood watch is currently in effect. So in addition to Aaron, we're also tracking Tropical Storm Dorian heading toward Puerto Rico, expected to head toward the eastern part of that island later on this evening, then eventually strengthen to a Category 1, perhaps Category 2 hurricane as it makes its way through the northern Bahamas over the upcoming weekend and eventually heading toward Florida. So a situation that certainly bears close watching. So on our forecast for later this afternoon, highs between 75 and 80 with rain becoming likely. Tomorrow, a dry day, highs between 80 and 85. Friday, there's a chance for a late day shower, but I think most of the state remains dry. It's going to be trending muggier as well as we end the week. But then behind a cold front for Saturday, less humid, a little bit cooler than Friday, highs near 80, mostly sunny. Sunday, we'll see increasing cloud cover, perhaps a late day shower, not a washout. And same can be said for Monday, not a washout, but some scattered showers will be possible, highs near 80. Then the humidity returns by Tuesday of next week with highs back in the mid 80s. So not a bad looking weekend, but not an ideal perfect one either.
All right. Sleep with your windows open, though. Nice and chilly at night.